Hello ROS developers, welcome to the ROS in 5 minutes video series by Deconstruct, your channel for everything ROS. I'm Bayodia Derenola, and in this video we'll be looking at what is ROS IP and then when to use it. But before anything else, remember to visit the Robotics Academy, our online academy where you find practical online ROS courses using simulated robots, no installation required. All you just need is a browser on your computer. You'll find a link to this academy in the video description. Now let's get to work. So we want to know what ROS IP is, and there's no better way than to see it at work. So for this, we are going to use another powerful tool from the construct. That's the ROS Development Studio. You find the link to this in the video description as well. You can create an account and follow this demo and do other things as well. So we are going to create a new project, what we call ROS Jet Air. So created, then we launch it by clicking here. Great. So for this, we come here to pick some tools. For this, we need two tools basically: Gazebo and then the shell. So ready, set, go. We are going to launch a sample Gazebo demo. Watch this place. So you can see simulation is running. So connected. And then we're done. So here we just launched the sample demo, but that's not where we're going. Before we do the next step, please notice this step. Launching ROS launch server. Okay, you can see the address here, and then you also see our ROS master URI address here. You can see the similarity between them, they have the same base IP address. So now we are going to do the same thing again, but this time we are going to override the ROS IP environment variable which we are looking at and see what happens. So in this case, I want to override it, so I don't want to set it. So go ahead. What's going on? Stop. So let's quickly check what is going. So notice here that ROS launch server is now launched on IP, what is this? And you know, previously it was launched here. And then secondly, we received a warning that invalid ROS IP empty string. And then okay, that was the warning, okay, meaning that it's not very important. But suddenly we started receiving an error here, couldn't resolve publisher host. So what happened here is because we did not set the ROS IP, the system used the host name of the PC, which is this, but then it tried to resolve that host name into an IP address. But unfortunately, you couldn't do that, so which is why we're getting this error. So to confirm that, let's check the host name of the machine. Okay, it's IP. Okay, the same thing you can see here, but unfortunately that did not resolve to an IP. So we're not going to why it's not, this is intentional for this environment. But now here, when we did not specify anything, the ROS IP, then we got to find the outcome. Yes, that's because we have the environment variable already set. If we do echo ROS IP, we see that it's set to 10.8.0.1, which is the same address that the ROS master URI is running on. Summing up, we use ROS IP when, for whatever reason, the host name of the machine cannot resolve to an IP address. Now also consider the scenario. Suppose we set the IP to something wrong, let's say 10. What do you think will happen? Alright, I will leave you to try that on your own and find out what happens. You can share your comment and experience in the comments area. I hope you have learned one or two things from this video. I hope to see you in the next video. So did you like the video? If you did, please give us a thumbs up. Remember to subscribe to our channel and press the bell for a new video every day. You can also leave us your thoughts in the comments area. Peace out. Udabo.